So most people just rely on medication because that's what they have offered to them. They don't realize therapy is a potential thing they could engage. Many times the doctors that they see only have medications to offer. They're not trained in therapy. They don't have time to engage in therapy. They don't have therapy services on site. And when they do recommend people go see a therapist or a counselor, 70% of the time people won't go. They feel insulted. They feel, my doctor's writing me off. They think I'm crazy or something. I'm not crazy. No, we're not talking crazy. We're talking about human experience, right? We're talking about people who get a recommendation from their physician that they engage in counseling services. The vast majority won't do it. Some people go, I don't have time for that. But they make time for doctor's appointments. They say, I don't got money for that. But they might buy medications for years on end, right? But what we see is they actually have very similar efficacy. Both work. This is a Consumer Reports report in 2010. Right? This is asking people who have been in the process of treatment for whatever mental health concern they have, what worked for you? You know, it's not a scientific study. It's just asking people. But in that sense, you get people's actual opinions, right? What do people think? Well, combining 1,500 reports of satisfaction for treatment of anxiety and depression, very common issues with people, how helpful they found their doctor or therapist, the degree of change they reported from their emotional state from beginning to end of treatment or the point they're asked, record on a 100-point scale, conversion there. Well, you find out people who have mostly medications as their treatment paradigm, about 70% of people find that effective within 1 to 6 visits. Now keep in mind, medication visits aren't going to be weekly, are they? You see your doctor, they prescribe you medication. Hopefully they'll want to follow up in a week or two or three just to see if everything's going okay with you. Hopefully they'll ask you about suicide risk, which is something I've shown you many people are averse to. They are trained to, but oftentimes won't. They'll make big assumptions about people being okay when maybe they're not. The majority of people who die by suicide, have seen their primary care provider in the previous month. In some ways, they might have been reaching out. Hopefully, people would ask you back. But mostly meds, you get equivalent. 1 to 6 visits, 7 or more visits. About 70% of people report an improvement. That's good. That's real good. Look here at talk only, though. About the same. Roughly the same, with a little bit more efficacy the longer you go. Now that might be a weekly thing. That might be a thing where you go each week to talk to somebody about your life where they're trained not to be talking about their own issues and not to be judging you, but to be asking you very specific types of questions, be formulating hypotheses in their mind about what might be going on and feeding that back to you in a way that you might be able to have some insight about yourself in a way that hadn't occurred to you before, then giving you suggestions for things you might try to alleviate problems in your life or to make your life more optimal. And you choose whether or not to do those. Nobody makes you do that. You choose to do that. And what we see with talk plus medication, a little bit better, which is consistent. It's pretty consistent with long-term research of a more scientific nature, which is to say this: medications work. But one of the problems with them is when you go off of them, you tend to have high levels of relapse, meaning the problem comes back. Talk therapy works equally as well, but you have a lower incidence of relapse because people have actually changed the circumstances that might have been surrounding the onset of the issues and or their interpretation of themselves or the issues and or adopted some kind of coping strategies that make them more capable of dealing more effectively with the stressors they find in their lives. So they actually build a different experience for themselves. And the best outcomes seem to be when you combine the two, especially with depression, where some of the core symptoms are lack of energy, apathy, right? And the idea is that if you take the medications, it might actually bring back the energy that you need to engage talk therapy effectively and get the maximal gains. So it works. Why are people scared of it? Why do they think there's something wrong with them? I've been to a therapist. I am a therapist, a licensed clinical psychologist. I had some difficulties in my life several years ago that were vexing me. I didn't meet criteria for any mental illness, although I was somewhat depressed. I didn't meet criteria for a diagnosis, but I used my EAP, employee assistance, and I went to a licensed clinical psychologist. I went about four times, and I got some insights. There I was, 40 years old, with all this training, and some stuff that was core to how I lived my life had not occurred to me until somebody else heard me telling them answers to the questions they had for me. They formulated some hypotheses, fed it back to me, and I contemplated it. And I was like, damn, that had not occurred to me before. Yes, there's probably some validity to that. Let me address it. And it helped. It helped me. And I ain't afraid to say that. Who would be? Most people. Why should they be? They shouldn't be. Life is hard. Life is suffering. There is help available if we'll only reach out and take it. So psychotherapy itself is the process by which mental health professionals, and there are a variety of types, licensed, trained, that help people recognize, define, and overcome psychological and interpersonal issues, difficulties between people. Does it do any good? Yes. Now we're looking at psychotherapy. We've already looked at biological therapies. Now we're looking at psychotherapy. It's just one meta-analysis. There's a bunch of studies that corroborate these findings. There's a placebo effect, and a pretty big one. Is that the case with biological therapies, drug therapy? Absolutely. It's a huge placebo effect. In other words, people who are at the brink of not knowing what to do, most people don't go, man, I should go to therapy. That's a good idea. That would help me really reassess my life and make a better plan for how to deal with difficulties I'm encountering, right? When they go to therapy, what? The shit has hit the fan, right? It is so bad that they're finally like, God, I guess I might as well go to therapy. Not, I should go, but I might as well because it's that bad for them, right? So offered any hope, whether it's in medicine or talk therapy, a lot of people start to improve right there because maybe they're past the point at which it got the worst, right? And it just gets better from there. It may be because they are activating their own coping mechanisms by going into therapy that they've actually passed a point and have started to actively and proactively engage in doing something differently. But what we see is people start responding in big ways just by going, whether it's medicine or talk therapy, right? But to be a empirically supported treatment, whether medicine or anything else, you have to do better than placebo. You have to do better than placebo. And we do about twice as good as placebo. And medicine's similar. So the placebo effect is real. It's important to understand it. You don't take it away from people. I've met people who said, man, I started taking antidepressants. I'm already feeling better. I've been taking about a week. I don't go, oh, you can't be feeling better. I haven't had time to work yet. Stop feeling better and wait for it to work. If you're feeling better, good. That's what we're after. That's what we want. Alleviation of suffering and hopefully some kind of engagement in a new way of looking at yourself or the world or a new way of engaging the world so that you can avoid similar situations in the future. So it does work. It's not just a bunch of touchy-feely bullshit, no matter what people say that you hear.